faithfulness, commitment, other words that are right now not in my brain cells, to describe being dedicated to a person, an organization, a family. These are the things, loyalty comes to mind now. These are the things that come to mind, especially as we're wrapping up our theme, What's in It for Me Today? And what's in it for me today is a committed relationship with one another. We're going to talk about commitment in a couple of different ways, but fundamentally that's what we're talking about, is commitment, is the opportunity to let people know that I'm with you, that I'm going to stand side by side with you, I am going to work with you, and the like. So please stick around. Today's episode of The Word is coming right at you.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Commitment. Loyalty, dedication, faithfulness, steadfastness. There's another word that I used to, it just came up with a couple of moments ago, to describe what we're going for today. And what are we going for today? It's that layer of commitment, a commitment to one another, to commitment to church, to commitment to family, and most of all, and most importantly, commitment to God. To get a commitment to God, to for God's guidance and direction in our lives today. And that's what we're going to talk about. Our passage from Hebrews chapter 3 today, verses 1 through 6, will help us kind of focus on the commitment to God angle that we have in the example of Moses and the example of Jesus. So I would invite you to grab your Bibles, please. And whether it's the electronic version or paper, and turn to Hebrews chapter 3, verses 1 through 6, and we'll see you on the flip side in just one moment. Do you have your Bibles ready? Here we go. Therefore, holy brothers, you who share in a heavenly calling, consider Jesus, the apostle and high priest of our confession, who was faithful to him who appointed him, just as Moses also was faithful in all God's house. For Jesus had been counted worthy of more glory than Moses, as much more glory as the builder of a house has more honor than the house itself. For every house is built by someone, but the builder of all things is God. Now Moses was faithful in all God's house as a servant, to testify to the things that were to be spoken later, but Christ is faithful over God's house as a son. And we are his house, if indeed we hold fast our confidence and our boasting in our hope. Okay, talking about builders, talking about architects, talking about planners, but also people who are committed to the building process. Let's think about it this way for a moment. You are building your home or having your home built. Now, in my case, when I had my house built, when I was living in Waxahachie, every lunch hour, I was over there watching, observing. And every dinner hour before Sherry and I had dinner, we were walking the house. And there were a few things we spotted as we walked through in relationship to the quality of the house and the quality of the construction. Caught a few things early. Here's the deal. Being the builder and being the house, that's what we're talking about a little bit in today's lesson. Being the house that God built. And I'm not talking about the structure that I'm in right now. I'm not talking about the structures. I'm talking about you and I. We are built into a spiritual house, to use another scriptural phrase. we are built into a house that is connected to one another, that is dedicated to one another, that we are built together based upon God's design for all of us. For example, I am firmly convinced that the makeup of Faith Lutheran Church and school right now is what needs to be made up. But it's not stagnant. It's never going to be stagnant. I was saying to somebody just the other day, there's one constant in church work: change. Things change all around us all the time. People change. People come in and come out. People are connected to one another, some for lifelong relationships, some for short terms. But the thing is, we're all connected to one another. We're all built into this house. We're all built together. And as ones who are built together, we have this bond with one another. And we also have this bond to the designer, the architect, and the general contractor. His name is God. His name is Jesus. Moses. Now, here's where I want to talk about the Moses and Jesus. Moses knew the plan. And Moses was a great leader in the context of knowing the plan. He was faithful, as it says here in verse 5. Now Moses was faithful in all God's house as a servant to testify to the things that were to be spoken later. So we've got this servant. Was Moses perfect in his servanthood? Did he get into the promised land? No. Why did he not get into the promised land? Well, in one episode, when the Israelites were grumbling and complaining about manna and food and no water and everything else like that, Moses went to God and said, God, what do I need? What do I do? These people are driving me absolutely out of my mind. And God said, okay, go over. There's a rock over there I want to point you to. Speak to that rock and the water will come out. Well, Moses forgot the instructions. He hit the rock with his staff. Now, God was still faithful to his people and still provided the water. But that cost Moses his position in the Holy Land. That one mistake. I'm not saying Moses was perfect any other time, but what I am getting at is Moses was dedicated to the work of God. Did he make mistakes? Yes. Did he fail in many ways? Yes. Was he perfect? No. Did he get the promise that God wanted for him? Oh, yeah. He got the promise of life, just not the promised land. Now, that's Moses. Moses, you can put yourself, myself, in the place of Moses. We are still the same sinful people. We try. We dedicate ourselves for a time. We dedicate ourselves for an opportunity. But the fundamental thing is we get frustrated. We get tired. We get struggling. We hurting. Pulling our hair out. Frustrated sometimes with either the lack of progress or just having to do too much sometimes. We run into that problem. Where's everybody else's commitment? Where everybody else? You know, we see that all the time. Oh, you're committed to this. You're committed to this. But are you committed to God? None of us are perfect. None of us are perfect. Let's get that out of our heads right now. None of us are perfect. However, we are saved. And in that salvation, in Christ, the one who is perfect, the one man, God, combined, 100% man, 100% God, that man, that one, is perfection. He is the builder of everything. He makes sure everything is done in accordance to the way it wants it to be done. So, we have Jesus. Here's what the writer of the letter to the Hebrews says in verse 6. But Christ is faithful over God's house as a son. And we are his house, if indeed we hold fast our confidence and our boasting in hope. Here's the thing. Confidence, loyalty, commitment, dedication, steadfastness, faithfulness, like I shared in the very opening, all of these things are part and parcel of who we are Yes, we fail. Yes, we're weak at it. Yes, we're not overtly committed, or our commitment's going one way out of whack versus another way. Our balance is out of whack. But still, that doesn't mean that God is not working with broken jars of clay, as Paul tells us we are. Here is the point. We are children of God. We live and we are the people of God in Christ Jesus, because we have been knit together, built into a house because of what Jesus had done for us. Think about what Jesus did. Ponder on that one, because that's so important. It's the motivating factor of everything. Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. Jesus, the one who died in order to save you and me from our weaknesses, from our sins. Jesus built us up into a church. Are we perfect? No. Are we perfected? Absolutely. So therefore, we therefore dedicate ourselves in our time, energy, and love for God. We exercise our dedication, our steadfastness, our confidence, our faithfulness, our loyalty, our steadfastness, our dedication, all these words. We do. We are. Because of what God did for us in Christ. That's ultimately the reason why. Now, today, for those of you who are members of faith watching this video this morning before running into church, today is a Commitment Sunday. We're asking you to commit your time and your talent and your treasure cards. Just bring them with you this morning to our time of service after the confession of faith, you know, the Apostles' Creed. We will have you bring those forward. So, be committed to God, because God is ultimately committed to you. He's built you into this wonderful house. All right, I'll see you guys in a little bit. You guys have a great morning. See you in church. Bye-bye.